So Marcus, you are our connectivity specialist. What have you prepared for today?
Actually, nothing and everything.
It's good to hear.
What do you want to see?
So how easy is it to integrate an existing device into a Zenon application?
Device such as?
As an IED out of the energy industry, for example.
That's why you prepared one.
I found one in my office, right.
Okay, so actually that's the Zen IED. It's an IEC 61850 server simulator.
Yeah,
let's see how we can integrate that in our project.
Yeah, please.
The variables of it.
Just the tags, yeah.
So actually what we would need is the IP address.
Right.
You have that?
Not in mind, but I'm pretty sure you have it.
Usually that's underneath, yes, yeah, we are lucky.
205, okay.
205.
Let's take that one.
Let's take that one. So actually in the variable section, you find here one branch driver.
Yeah.
Here in that driver branch, you can create all drivers, the connectivity you need for your project.
I guess for any protocol.
With a right click or here on the corner, new driver, you can insert a new driver, which gives you then the choice of this huge list, all connectivity possibilities in Zenon.
No, that's huge. Yeah.
It is, actually. And we want to connect now with the IEC protocol, the IEC
61850. Yeah.
And here we have all the choice of these protocols. One of it is 61850 driver. With OK, I just select this driver, and we see here the first configuration page.
Which is standard, I guess, for all the drivers.
Standard page, yes. But we just want to integrate that now very fast, or I want to show how fast it really works. I just leave everything standard and default.
Okay.
So we already take a look that the settings are default settings and work in most of the cases. So just go directly to the connections page, say here new connection, and well, big dialogue because the choices in this driver are big.
A lot of options in there, yes.
As I said, no worries about these settings. Take the standard setting. Everything we need to do is we change the IP address.
This was the 205, as far as I remember.
I think the network is 250 and 205.
That's right.
That's all.
Okay.
I just say OK, and with OK, I close that dialog. Driver is created
new item
and
is there?
Configured.
Okay. That's easy.
That's easy. Now we want to create our database.
So the tags.
For example, a circuit breaker. It's an bay controller. It has also a circuit break, small one. Yeah. Circuit breaker. We want to monitor the circuit breaker, or maybe also command it. How can we get that data? Actually, this driver offers an import possibility, online or offline import. We have the device here. We can choose the online import. With a right click on the driver, you can select here import variables from driver.
Driver now, okay.
And if you select that, you have the choice either the PLC browsing, device online, or the file browsing from the file. I just, only thing I do, I select the server, the connection we just created.
We just created, yeah.
Say OK, and the driver.
So this is already connected now to the device?
It's already connected to the device, yes. Well, driver directly browses the object model in the server and gives us all the.
All the information.
All the tags, yes.
And just what's left is just to select what I need?
Yeah, of course. Well, in energy, it is, of course, you need to know what you want. Yeah. In that special case, we want to have this circuit breaker data. I know it's a CSWI, a controllable switch, so I can filter also here, because you see 6,000 variables, that's
a lot.
Huge.
This small piece.
But with a small filter like CSWI, and also I want the position data, so I filter again with POS, and with that filter, I get just a small selection. Well, small, 155, still enough, but because of the object model, you know, you find already these variables you need, like control model, that you know what type of command is needed, or the control value, the command variable itself,
what I need.
Or maybe for monitoring, the most important thing, the ST-val that you see here, the feedback variable. Yeah. Let's just take this ST-val and with OK, it would then just import the variable. And we see here in our variable list, the variable is imported, everything in there. And you see also addressing, so symbolic address, everything.
There's nothing else I have to take care about. So at that moment, I'm finished. The connectivity is there and it's running. Cool.
That's right.
Very impressive. I know now this was a very well prepared showcase, but I've prepared also another one.
Okay.
Are you sure we can handle this baby here also in this short time period? It's now not energy related. Do you think we have a chance?
Oh, let's have a try.
Let's try.
So what we have here is, okay, it's a symmetric S7-1500. Yeah, so as I showed before, first we need the driver of our choice. Actually, we will find it in the Siemens section. Okay. Let's see in the drivers, create the driver first. Just follow the same
procedure,
procedure before. New driver, here there is then the section Siemens, where you find all related, of course, they have a lot of different hardware.
Okay.
And one of it is here, the S7 driver for S7-1200-1500. Okay. Well, that's F1500, so that's the driver of our choice. With OK, I select that driver. And
waiting for the config.
Waiting for the config.
There it is.
Same again, first stage quite unique. Then, well, here, well, one thing we need to change, because you did not give me the project, so we will browse it offline from the PLC probably. So symbols from PLC, that's what we want. And then same as before, in the connections, I just create a new connection. Only thing I do is here, I change the IP address, you know that? We can take a look at it. That's here, okay, 202.
Okay.
It's good in the same, it's in the same range, so 202. Only thing, of course, we need to do is, need to set it correct, of course. And, well, we need to plug it in.
Plug it in, I guess.
Yeah. Otherwise, that's a little bit tricky. Okay, let's see.
That's also the tricky, the sticky part. Yep.
You hear it? And same thing here. Once the driver is created or in the project, we can, with a right click, import variables from driver.
Again, same directly from the device.
Thing. Here, it's a little bit different. Well, configured PLC, we just select
the one we had.
Connection, yes. And with OK, it gives us a pre-selection of what we want. So you have here data blocks, the data blocks that are stored in, I can pre-select. But yeah, let's just the markers or the IOs, that's all in the text section with OK. You see here.
This one we know already, yeah.
Here the this dialog, the outputs, the inputs, markers, clock markers, you can just choose whatever you want and then just hit OK, import them.
We did it in 2 minutes. Marcus, I must say this was very impressive. Thanks a lot. As a small thank you, I've prepared a t-shirt for you.
Oh, thank you. T-shirts are always welcome.
Thank you for meeting me at Engineer's Kitchen and hopefully I'll see you soon again in another episode.
Thank you. Yeah, I would like to.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
What a delicious episode of COPA-DATA's Engineer's Kitchen. If you are still hungry, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.